excited that you were here again with me at Bible Story Station. You guys should be here helping me tell this story. Guys, I am so excited. But before we get into our story, I've got a question for you. And actually, it's a pretty big, pretty important question. Are you ready? Here's my question. Where do you belong? Are there places where you feel totally comfortable? Maybe it's with your friends at school or your family members. Are there places where you feel like no matter what, you can always, always, always be yourself? Well, I want you to know that you definitely 1,000% belong here. And by here, I kind of mean two places. I mean here at Press Play VBS Online. We are so excited that you are joining us and watching these videos and hanging out with us in the chat. Guys, this has been like the best week of my summer, and we're only on day 2. But I don't just mean at Press Play VBS. I also mean at our churches. At Edmonton Chinese Lions Church, at Edmonton Alliance Church. Guys, whatever church you're at, I hope you feel like you belong. Because I'm speaking for both Pastor Phoebe and myself. That you 100% do. Every single person is welcome, and we are so excited when you come to hang out with us. After all, a church is a place where people come together to learn how they can live more like Jesus, right? And Jesus gave us the most perfect example of how we can live like we belong and show others that they belong. Jesus taught us what it means to be a good friend, because while he was here on earth, he treated everybody with kindness, love, and respect. He showed friendship to them. He made them feel like they belong. You know, we can kind of see that in the way that Jesus chose his first group of friends, the disciples. Now, we know that Jesus is the Son of God. And I don't know about you, but if I was the Son of God, I think I would probably choose friends who were like really pretty, who were really smart, and, you know, they should probably be good at math, because I'm not good at math. And maybe they should be really fast with the sports. You know what? I think they should pretty much just be like the best of the best people. But that's not how Jesus chose his disciples. Sheepy and I are going to be helping you guys learn about the first friends, the disciples who Jesus picked, and how he went about picking those people. Plus, I've got some extra special guest stars with us today to help us learn through music. So we pick up our story today at the Sea of Galilee. Jesus was there, he was teaching the people, and guys, the people had already figured out that Jesus was not just a regular guy. There was something super special about him, so they all went to go hear what Jesus had to say. There were so many people crowding around Jesus that nobody could hear him. So Jesus decided into a boat, and he told the guy who owned the boat to push away from the shore and go out to the lake. Now, I don't know if you guys know this, but I've learned that sound travels way better over water than it does over land. So Jesus was out in the middle of the lake, he was far away from the crowd, and his voice traveled loudly over the water, kind of like my voice on the microphone, and all of the people could finally hear him. So Jesus started to teach, and the people started to listen. Now before we continue on with our story, I'm going to tell you a little bit about the guy who owned this boat. His name was Simon, and lots of us know him as Peter, and he was a fisherman. He was not super important at all. In fact, people often overlooked him or forgot about him. But what's amazing is that when Jesus finished speaking to the people, he turned spoke directly to Peter. You know what? Let's read in the Bible and find out what Jesus said to Peter. We're going to be turning today to Luke, chapter 5, verse 4. And it says, "Go out into the deep water and let down your nets so that you can catch the fish." And the next verse, verse 5, is going to tell us what Peter answered. It says this, "Master, we've worked hard all night and we haven't caught any fish, but as you said so, I will let down the nets." So, let's see. Special guest number 1. Do you have a song that can help us understand Peter a little bit more in this moment? Maybe it will help us imagine what that conversation with Jesus looked like. All right, you guys ready? Hit it.
Well, there I was on the Sea of Galilee, cleaning up from a boring night. We set our nets out hoping for some fish, but we never even got a bite. As a fisherman, I got count of my net, I saw a man who had seen before. It was Jesus, the one who did miracles, why he even healed my mom and law. And he said, "Oh, Simon Peter, sir, let down those nets, you'll see. I think it might be worth your while, we never had a friend like me. Now listen, normally I'd rather take a swim, but this was Jesus asking me. I ain't never had a friend like him."
Wow, thanks Peter, that was some amazing singing. And guys, it's true. Peter normally wouldn't have felt like he wanted to go out of his way to go fishing again the next day, when he had already spent the whole night fishing and had caught zero fish. But since Jesus asked him to do it, that's what he and his friends did. They let out their nets into the lake, and they waited to see what would happen. Now, what do you guys think? Do you think that they caught any fish? I want you to leave me a comment in the live chat. Let's see. Thumbs up for lots of fish. Thumbs down for no fish. What do you guys think? I mean, you've been out fishing all night the night before. You haven't caught anything. I'm not a very good fisherman, but I'm pretty sure that the fish don't like to be caught in the middle of the day. I've heard that they like it in the morning or at night. I feel like they're probably not going to catch anything, right? I don't know though, some of you guys are putting thumbs up. I'm wrong. If I had put a thumbs down, I would have been wrong. Because you know what's amazing? Peter didn't just catch a couple of fish. He caught a lot of fish. Like a whole lot. They actually caught so many fish that the nets they had let down into the lake started to break apart because there were so many fish and the fish were so heavy. They caught so many fish that Peter had to wave to another boat to get his friends to bring the boat over so that they could move some of the fish from their boat into the other boat. And even then, both of the boats started to sink because there were just way too many fish. There was something super clear to Peter and to his friends in that moment, that there was something special about Jesus. He was not just an ordinary guy, but Jesus told him not to be afraid. Jesus said to him, "Peter, from now on, you're not gonna fish for fish anymore. You're going to fish for people." Now, at the time, I don't think Peter had a clue what that meant. I bet he was super confused. But what Jesus was telling him was that he was going to spend the rest of his life going all over the world, okay, maybe not the world, but all over the area, telling people about how they could live their lives for Jesus and have a forever relationship with Jesus. Immediately, Peter and his friends James and John pulled their boats up onto the shore because they knew what they needed to do. They needed to leave their boats and their fish and everything else behind, and they needed to follow Jesus. And guys, they were not the only ones. Later, Jesus came across a man who was sitting in a tax collector booth. This man's name was Levi. Now, tax collectors like Levi at the time weren't super popular because their job was to collect taxes from the people and pay to the Roman government. But the Roman government was a foreign government, so it was kind of like taking money from the people and giving it to the enemy. Not good, Shiki. Not good. But it didn't just stop there, because the tax collectors also paid their salary out of the money that they took from the people. Let me put it this way. It's kind of like if I told you guys that BBS boxes were $20 and you paid me $20 and I gave it to the church for your boxes, that would be good, right? But if I told you that BBS boxes were $30 and I took the $20 and I gave it to the church, but I took that extra $10 and I like put it in my pocket and I saved it for when I really wanted ice cream at McDonald's. Not so good, right? You guys would not be happy with me at all. That would be cheating you out of your money. And that's kind of what the tax collectors were doing. They were cheating the people out of their money, and they were stealing from them. Now, we don't know whether or not Levi was actually doing this, but what we do know is that it was a super, super big deal for Jesus to want to be friends with Levi. But Jesus went to Levi, and he told him to leave everything behind and follow him. And you know what he did? Just like Peter, James, and John, the fishermen that we heard from earlier, Levi left everything behind and followed Jesus. Now, you guys are super in luck because I also have Levi here with me today to sing us another song. So, Levi, do you think you could sing us a song maybe about what Jesus said to you that day when he came to your booth? Let's listen in.
Cause a big backlash, come follow me. He said to my booth, come follow me. I know he speaks the truth, know that I'll go with him anywhere he wants to be, and I'll gladly follow his request. Come follow me.
Nice, Levi. That's an awesome song. Now, guys, you can probably see at this point that Jesus had a different way of choosing his friends. He had a different way of treating people than what was normal at the time. He chose a bunch of fishermen and tax collectors to be his disciples. Now Levi was so excited about what Jesus had called him to. He was so excited that he was friends with Jesus that he decided he was going to throw a huge banquet. But he wasn't going to invite all of these super important people. He was going to invite tax collectors, or fishermen, or sinners, or just regular people, so that they could all come and celebrate together. But the religious leaders at the time, they were called the Pharisees, were super not happy about the friends that Jesus was taking. They were so unhappy about it that they started to get together and they started to whisper to each other. And they started to complain about what Jesus was doing. They went and they complained and they said, why do you eat and drink with tax collectors and sinners? Now, my last special guest for today is actually a Pharisee. It was a very big deal for me to get him to come sing with us today, so everyone make sure at the end you give him a big round of applause in the chat. But Mr. Pharisee, do you maybe have a song for us about that day? Maybe a song that would, you know, help us understand how you Pharisees were feeling. You do? That's awesome. Okay, can we hear it now?
Thank you.
Tax Collector a round of applause. That was amazing. It was phenomenal. I cannot believe that my ears got to hear that. Guys, it wasn't really that good, but the Tax Collector used to want to build themselves up and remake themselves. It was super important. They felt like, you know, they felt like they were better than everyone else because they followed all of the rules and then some extra rules that they came up with. The Pharisees could not believe that Jesus wanted to hang out with fishermen and tax collectors and ordinary people. But Levi and Peter and James and John and the rest of the disciples saw things very differently. They were so excited. They couldn't contain their joy that Jesus wanted to hang out with them. Let's listen to what Jesus said to one of the Pharisees when they went to him and complained about him hanging out with sinners. I'm going to read verses 31 and 32 of Luke chapter 5. It says this: healthy people don't need a doctor. Sick people do. I have not come to get those who think they are right with God to follow me. I have come to get sinners to turn away from their sins. Now guys, here's the thing. Jesus could have chosen the Pharisees to be his disciples. He could have chosen the smartest people. Maybe he would have had like a math-off competition to find out who was smart. Or maybe he would have picked the fastest people and had them all have a race so that he could see who would be his next disciples. But that's not who he chose. He chose people like Peter and James and John and Levi. He chose people that were ordinary people. But here's the thing. Jesus didn't say that he came for the perfect people. Jesus said that he came for everyone. He came for people exactly how they are. He came to show love to everyone and to make everyone feel like they belong. Even you, sheepy, he came for you too. Guys, aren't you glad when you think about the fact that you belong to Jesus? That nothing you could ever think or do or feel would surprise Jesus because he knows it. He knows you and he still loves you. And he invites you to be his friend and actually to be part of his family. That's incredible. I think that's actually a super great reason to have confidence. Remember our big thought for today. I can have confidence because I belong. Let's pray and give thanks to God for giving us a place to belong. Jesus, I thank you so much for the way that you treated people. I thank you that you didn't come and choose the important people or the really smart people or the religious leaders. I thank you that you came for everyone to show love to everyone. I thank you that you treated everyone like your friend, that you treated everyone like they belong. And I pray that we will have confidence in the fact that we do belong, that you know us and you love us. And I pray that that confidence will help change our hearts so that we can treat those around us like they belong too. Whether they look different than us or they are interested in different things, I pray that these things won't matter and that instead we will just be filled with your love for them. I pray this in your name. Amen. Okay guys, thanks for hanging out with me and Sheepy. I think I gotta go put Sheepy down for an hour. Sheepy's looking a little tired. And remember, I'm a good shepherd to Sheepy, but not as good of a shepherd as Jesus is, right? Have a great break before our next session, and I will see you there.